and will be full of presentations in our format from poster, poster discussion, oral presentation, and concluding today with the first of the two presidential symposium. And today, as yesterday, we start with a press briefing in which we selected a few scientific presentations that will be presented today in the Congress. And today we will deal with three different tumors. All of them are considered among the big killers because one presentation will deal with aspects related to the timing and the type of surgery in breast cancer. A second presentation will deal with a very important problem in prostate cancer. You know that prostate cancer is a hormone-sensitive, hormone-dependent cancer, but unfortunately, all patients that will survive during treatment with metastatic disease, sooner or later, will develop resistance to hormone treatment, and we will have a new hope with a new kind of drug that will block the hormone receptor in prostate cancer. Finally, a presentation will be on an important subgroup of lung cancers in which we have now a powerful molecular target that can be used for driving the treatment with selective specific inhibitors. So we will start with Dr. Carmen Criscitiello from the European Institute of Oncology in Milan in Italy. And later in the day, she will have a presentation on the discrepancy between high pathological complete response rate and low breast conserving surgery following neoadjuvant therapy. And she will give us an analysis from a very important multicenter neoadjuvant trial in this disease setting. Please, Carmen.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and thanks for coming. So today, I will present during the afternoon session in the early breast cancer a sub-study we conducted within the NEOALTO trial. Basically, the NEOALTO trial is a trial conducted in patients with HER2-positive early breast cancer in the new adjuvant setting, meaning preoperative treatment. So this trial assessed the differences between two drugs alone plus a chemotherapeutic, so lapatinib and trastuzumab, that are two biological agents, and their combination. And the combination treatment showed a double that the rate of pathological complete response, which is the disappearance of the tumor, nearly doubles the efficacy of this treatment. However, what we noticed afterwards is that this impressive result did not translate into higher rate of breast conservation, which was around 40% across the three treatment arms. So we moved forward and we decided to investigate the different factors that may have affected the choice of surgery in patients enrolled in the NEOALTO trial. So what we noticed is that planned surgery itself, that means the type of plan, the type of surgery that would have been offered to the patient before the treatment, is something that resulted in more breast-conserving surgery. So patients initially planned to receive breast-conserving surgery were actually more likely to go through with it. On the contrary, patients with a multifocal or multicentric tumor at diagnosis and patients with no expression of the estrogen receptor status and patients with a residual palpable mass after neoadjuvant therapy were less likely to have breast-conserving surgery. So we then decided to redo the same analysis, but excluding the planned surgery among these factors. So in addition to what we already knew, by doing that, two other factors emerged, being the tumor size and the geographic region where the treatment was given. Basically, we saw that patients diagnosed with tumors were more likely to be treated with breast-conserving surgery compared to patients diagnosed with a T4 tumor at baseline, so with a larger tumor at baseline. And patients treated in developed countries, as defined by the OECD definition, were more likely to be treated with breast-conserving surgery compared to patients treated in developing countries. So basically, what emerged from this analysis is that the decision of surgical treatment post-new adjuvant therapy is mainly based on baseline characteristics rather than on characteristics after treatment. And this is crucial because we observe that this finding is independent of treatment arm and response to treatment. So the factors that mainly influence the decision of the type of surgery were the type of planned surgery itself at diagnosis, the multicentricity or multifocality of the tumor, and the ER negativity. So two other factors influenced the choice of planned surgery itself at diagnosis, which were the tumor size and the geographic region, as I already mentioned you. So what we want to tell today, it's there is a need for a clear consensus on the role of breast-conserving surgery, especially in patients who respond to new adjuvant therapy. And this will ultimately translate the progress that we have already done in new adjuvant therapies into improved breast conservation rates. So this could spare more women from receiving radical treatments like mastectomies.
Thank you, Pat.
Thank you.